Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss a single phase half wave controlled rectifier with RL load and with freewheeling diode, right? RL load with freewheeling diode, okay? So circuit diagram, the same circuit diagram as that of the RL load, but only thing is we have added one diode here which is connected across the RL branch, that is a load branch. Okay, so same supply voltage Vs is equal to Vm into sine of omega t. From omega t is equal to 0 to pi, Vs is positive, pi to 2 pi, Vs is negative. Okay, next Is is the supply current. Voltage across thyristor is Vt, current flowing through thyristor is It. Voltage across load is V0, current flowing through load is I0, and current flowing through the freewheeling diode is Ifwd, right? Ifwd. Okay, next, and these are the waveforms we are going to discuss. The operation, circuit operation of RL load with freewheeling diode. Okay, so let us first check from omega t is equal to 0 to alpha. For omega t is equal to 0 to alpha, for omega t is equal to 0 to alpha. Yes, for omega t is equal to 0 to alpha, what is Vs? Vs is positive. Okay, so when Vs is positive, right, but thyristor will be in the forward bias mode, but we have not applied the gate signal. So thyristor will be in the forward blocking mode. Okay, what about this diode? Yes, this diode will be in the off state only. Okay, because circuit is not completing, thyristor is in the off state. Okay, next, so equivalently, can we draw the circuit? Yes, we are having the supply voltage Vs. Next, thyristor is in the open circuit mode, R L. Okay, so here Vs we are having. Supply voltage is positive, this is Vt, this current is It, here it is Is. Okay, next, diode is in the off state, right? This is a R, this is a L, here it is a V0, this current is I0. Okay, and this one is Ifwd, current flowing through freewheeling diode. Okay, so if you check the circuit from 0 to alpha, yes, thyristor is in the off state. Okay, so current will not flow from source towards the load. Okay, so can we write? Yes, I0 is 0. Yes, I0 is equal to It is equal to Is, all are 0. Okay, so here 0 to alpha, I0 is 0. Next, what is the V0? If load current is 0, load voltage will be 0 only, because it is an impedance into load current. Okay, so it is a 0. Okay, next, so can we write KVL to the loop? It is a plus Vs minus Vt minus V0 is equal to 0. Out of this, V0 is 0, right? So therefore we can write Vt is equal to Vs. Thyristor voltage is equal to supply voltage. Okay, next, what is the freewheeling diode current? Freewheeling diode is in the off state, so Ifwd is equal to 0 ampere. Okay, so if you check the waveforms from 0 to alpha, yes, V0 is 0, I0 0, Vt is equal to Vs, right? V0 0, I0 0, and Vt is equal to Vs. Okay, this is for omega t is equal to 0 to alpha. Next, at alpha we are going to apply the gate signal to the thyristor. Okay, so let us discuss the circuit operation from alpha to pi. Circuit operation from alpha to pi. So it is a alpha to pi, right? So at alpha we are applying the gate signal, so thyristor T will be in the on state. Okay, thyristor T will turn on, so mode of operation will be forward conduction mode. Okay, so now thyristor will act as a short circuit, so Vt is equal to 0 volt, right? Next, if we apply the KVL, we will be getting V0 is same as that of the supply voltage. V0 is same as that of the supply voltage, right? But here in the circuit we are having the inductor, right? As we know, the inductor is the element which opposes the change in the current. At alpha or before alpha, current flowing through the inductor, yes, it was a zero, right? So whether the current flowing through the inductor will increase suddenly at alpha, not possible. Okay, so therefore current flowing through the inductor go on increasing slowly. Inductor stores the energy, right? So during the alpha to pi, inductor go on storing the energy, and I0 is increasing slowly, right? So here, yes, if you check from alpha to pi, V0 is same as that of the supply voltage. I0 is increasing slowly, thyristor is in the on state. What is the Vt? Vt will be equal to 0 volt, right? Vt will be equal to 0 volt. Okay, means at alpha, at omega t is equal to pi, yes, current flowing through the load, that is the current flowing through the inductor, it is a positive, and positive current means the current direction is in the downward direction. Okay, next. So after pi, what will happen? Let us discuss. So from omega t is equal to pi to beta, from omega t is equal to pi to beta. Yes, it is from pi to beta. Yes, what will happen? So if you check, after omega t is equal to pi, supply voltage polarity is reversed, right? So here it is a plus and here it is minus. Okay, so this supply voltage will try to circulate current in this direction. Okay, but our inductor will not allow the sudden change in the current or the sudden reversal of the current. Okay, so whatever the energy stored by the inductor, inductor will try to release the energy in order to maintain the same current. Okay, so now inductor can release the energy either through the freewheeling diode or through the, or in opposition to that of the supply voltage. Okay, so inductor is having the two paths available. One is inductor can release the energy through the freewheeling diode. Second one is inductor can release the energy in opposition to that of the supply voltage. But as well as the current is having the tendency that it always follows the path with the lesser opposition. Okay, so here if you check, in the freewheeling diode path there is no opposition for the flow of current. Okay, so therefore inductor will release the energy through the freewheeling diode. So please be careful, right? After pi, inductor is releasing the energy through the freewheeling diode, right? So freewheeling diode will be in the on state from pi to beta. Okay, so when freewheeling diode is in the on state, right? So freewheeling diode is in the on state, at that time what will happen? Yes, this diode will be acting as a reverse bias, so that's why this will be in the open circuit mode. Okay, second thing, yes, what is the voltage across the load? V0 is nothing but the voltage across these two points, right? Again, voltage across these two points is nothing but the voltage across the conducting diode. Okay, what is the voltage across conducting diode? It is a zero, right? So that's why V0 is equal to 0 volt, right? Next, if we apply the KVL to the loop, yes, we can write it as a minus Vs, minus Vt, minus V0 is equal to 0. Out of that, V0 is 0, right? So can we write it as Vt is equal to minus Vs? Okay, so after pi till beta, Vt is minus Vs. It is same as that of the supply voltage, but it is a negative. Okay, so Vt is equal to minus Vs. Are you getting the point? Okay, now inductor is releasing the energy, means what? Inductor is giving the energy, right? So that's why what will happen, as time increases, yes, the energy decreases, right? So due to that, the current decreases. Okay, so if you check, from omega t is equal to pi to beta, V0 is equal to 0, I0 is decreasing, freewheeling diode is in the on state, and what is the Vt? Vt is same as that of the supply voltage, right? Vt is same as that of the supply voltage. Okay, so till beta, inductor releases the energy. Okay, means at beta, inductor has released the fully energy. What is the beta? Beta is nothing but the extinction angle. Beta is the extinction angle. Okay, next. So from beta to 2 pi, what will happen? Let us discuss. From omega t is equal to beta to 2 pi, what will happen? Yes, so if you check, from beta to 2 pi, now inductor has released the fully energy, right? Means inductor is not having any energy to release. Okay, again, from beta to 2 pi, supply voltage is negative, right? So it is plus here, minus here. This thyristor will be in the reverse bias mode, right? Also, inductor has released the energy, so that's why this for freewheeling diode will be also in the off state mode. Okay, so it is like a circuit will be at the rest position. Okay, because this thyristor is in the off state. Okay, so therefore can we write current in the circuit I0 is equal to 0 ampere? Okay, current in the circuit is 0 ampere. Next, which is same as that of the Is, which is equal to It. Okay, what is the V0? V0 is equal to 0 because current is not flowing through the load. Okay, next, so what is the Vt? Can we write Vt is equal to minus Vs? You can apply the KVL, you will be getting Vt is equal to minus Vs. Okay, freewheeling diode current is 0. Freewheeling diode current is 0. Is this clear? So from beta to 2 pi, if you check, from beta to 2 pi, yes, what is the V0? 0. What is the I0? It is a 0. What is the Vt? Vt is same as that of the supply voltage, but it is a negative. Okay, and after 2 pi, the same cycle goes on repeating. Okay, so please be careful. Thyristor T is in the on state from alpha to pi, and from pi to beta, freewheeling diode will be in the on state. If you compare this circuit with only RL load without freewheeling diode, yes, here we will be getting V0. Yes, negative pulse is absent. Okay, so here the V0 average will be more compared to that of the previous case, right? Next, during alpha to pi, I0, Is, It all are same. During pi to beta, It and Is are 0, but I0 is non-zero.
Are you getting the point? During pi to beta, I0 is non-zero, but IS and IT are zero. So be careful here, IS and I0, both are different, okay? Both are not same. Is this clear? Okay? So this is about the circuit operation of single phase half wave controlled rectifier with RL load and with freewheeling diode. In the next video, we are going to discuss the derivations of this circuit. Thank you.